Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, and in this video, we're going to take a look at using 3D transforms to create a card flip animation, which you can use in your wallet experiences or festive and spooky interactions. Alright, here we are in Adobe XD with a Halloween-themed design I've been piecing together using assets from Adobe Stock, and I'd love to use these two as the front and backs of the card. Here's how it's done. The first and most obvious step is to place each side on top of one another. This can be done by dragging or using the alignment options within the Properties Inspector. Now, here's where things get a bit specific. Selecting the purple design, which we're going to use as the back of the card, we'll want to start it off in the flipped position. And to accomplish this, we'll want to enable 3D transforms within the Properties Inspector, or using the Command or Control T shortcut, and then rotate it negative 180 degrees around the Y axis. Our principal designer, Talon Wadsworth, said it best. Think of it like a double-sided piece of paper. When looking at it from the front, the back side is inverted. Next, to help XD understand and swap the order of the sides, let's set up the Z position values. The front of the card will be set to 1, and the back, negative 1. You can also adjust the Z position using the on-canvas gizmo, but if you're specific about the values, the Properties Inspector is your best bet. Finally, to help us flip the entire card on the next screen, both sides can be placed into a group. Alright, let's duplicate the artboard and work on the back. As a quick side note, if you're watching this around Adobe Max, component states are not currently supported with 3D transforms, but if you're watching it at some point in the future, you may just be in luck. On this artboard, we'll want to make a few adjustments so that the back of the card is visible. First, we can rotate the entire group 180 degrees. This won't immediately bring the back of the card forward, so like we did on the first artboard, we can dive in and tweak the Z position. 1 for the back, and negative 1 for the front. That's looking a bit better. To add a touch more perspective, I'm going to select the entire group one more time, move it on up, then use the gizmo to add some rotation along both axes. I also have a simple blurred rectangle I'm using as a shadow, which I'll rotate and drop the opacity. Alright, it's time for the magic. Switching over to prototype mode, I'll select the card on the first artboard, and then drag the wire over to the next. Within the Properties Inspector, I'll stick with the tap trigger, and then make sure Auto Animate is selected under Type. For the initial flip, a snap with a duration of around 0.8 seconds should look nice. A trigger can also be set up from the back of the card to the front, and instead of a snap, I'll go with a nice ease in out. Let's see this in action. The play button at the top will launch the preview, where I can tap to flip the card over, and then tap again to reset it. Of course, now that the interaction has been set up, changes can be made to add additional motion. For instance, on the sides that are not visible, the various layers can be shifted and even moved outside the mask so that they settle into place as the animation is occurring. You know what? Let's take this up one more level. Back within prototype mode, I can add an additional action to the initial tap trigger that was set up a few moments ago. And to up the spookiness of this interaction, I'll pop in an audio file that will play on tap. Let's see it all in action one more time. And that's how you can create a card flip using Adobe XD. If you end up creating one of your own, tweet it to @Pinsky so I can check it out. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Be sure to subscribe for more tips and tricks, and I'll see you all next time.